We're going to begin the service for Dean. Thank you for coming. I know most of you are relations, but to the friends, and thank you. Immediately following the service here at the funeral home, everyone is invited to the Riverwalk for a meal and fellowship and share some more memories that we couldn't talk about, and hopefully they got cookies. I kind of lit up when the boxes started coming. So, out of respect to Pastor and to the family, if you do have a cell phone, if you could please turn it on to vibrate or off so it doesn't go off during the service. Also, we are Zooming the service, so if there's any reason why you don't want to be on the Zoom or you do have your mask, slipping on, so just a disclaimer for that. So, thank you.
Thank you. welcome the family and friends that is here today to remember the life of Sarah Brewis. At this time, we're going to have Megan and Alex come and share good memories to granddaughters that love their grandma very much. I'm going to have them come at this time.
If you've ever met our grandma, then you've been well fed. Do you want some more? Something else? Is that enough? How about some gravy? Maybe some salt and pepper? Do you need a drink? Water? Beer? Let's get you a Coke. Or if you like, I have a nice glass of wine in the fridge. That was our grandma, an amazing woman who was kind, loving, and touched the hearts of all she met. You knew her by one of her many names: Mom, Mum, Sarah Jean, Grandma Boo, Gigi Ma, or Jeannie Boo. Or maybe you just knew her by her infectious laugh. No matter what name you knew her by, she would make you feel special and loved. She was the youngest of two girls raised in a small home on Westbrook. She lived a few blocks away from her grandpa, whom she met in preschool, and that's where their love story began. They enjoyed summer camps and joint family outings to the lake. She was hesitant to date grandpa because she was 10 weeks older than him. We consider ourselves lucky that he charmed her early on, and they were married for 60 years before grandpa passed away. When grandma talked about her childhood, she spoke of how proud she was of her Irish parents gaining citizenship. Her best friend was Rose. She didn't have to walk through 12 feet of snow, but she took multiple buses across town to continue to spend Saturdays together. She played softball, and although she never attended college, she had her own sorority girls, her best girlfriends, Joanne, Janet, Laura, Jean, and Mary. They met monthly for lunches for years until they retired and moved further away from each other. Grandma went to a special school, Shirley Open Air, for children less fortunate. She always talked about the fact that she got breakfast, lunch, and a nap every day. She attended school with Ronnie and Colson, who were two of Grandpa's best friends. She was so proud of her career that started at Montgomery Ward in the personnel department. She loved that job and talked about it often. She was so proud of the bedroom furniture she had purchased for her and Grandpa, and as you can imagine, it was the only furniture set for their whole life. She was such a wonderful woman who cared so much about her children. She was a Sunday school teacher, classroom mom, and your biggest fan. Grandma did not claim to have a favorite, but she let you know that Carrie was the only one they planned on. He was her big boy, which became Bimbo and longtime Bim. She loved her big boy, even the time that he drove her home from work on a snow day, just to park on the larger snow pang, making her exit quite challenging. She was the loudest cheering fan at the hockey rink and basketball courts, and just as loud cheering on the Lions, clearly her favorite team. Grandma was always positive. She saw the good side of every situation in life and the best in every person. She taught her children responsibility at a young age. They had chores and play clothes and never sat on the furniture when coming in from outside. She would always send you to school or church unless you were sick or you would spend the entire day in bed. To this day, all of her children rarely call in sick to work.
Grandma was not a fussy person. She pulled any outfit together with a red lipstick. As we got older, she became your best friend, the person you call for anything and everything. And as she had the most common saying, come when you can, but take care of yourself first. I'll be here. Grandma grew up in the Depression. She was as thrifty as they came. Now saying this, the refrigerator kind of scared us the most. She never threw away anything. Way before it was cool to toast your Cheez-Its, she would toast them to make them crisp again and fresh. She could cater to anyone at the table, and breakfast was always a family favorite. Bacon, hash, eggs, biscuits on donkey pancakes, and believe it or not, she even made scrambled eggs for all the dogs. She had a vegetable garden and a little red bucket to collect all of the fresh veggies. There was not a grandchild that did not help water and harvest from their garden, or plant and water the flowers. She made special enchiladas on Friday nights or for Grandma's week. She would make her special pizzas or cookies with the grandchildren. Fudge making was so much special, especially if you were the one who got to taste the test drop. She was the mother of the bride several times, and grandmother even more. She danced at all the weddings. She was the cool grandmother that made sure everyone was having a great time. She was even known to twirl on the dance floor with Fernando, a frequent family guest to weddings. She played basketball with the grandkids and played countless games of Yahtzee, Uno, Skippo, Rummy Cube. She went to all the special events and games, cheered even louder if you can imagine, for her grandkids. Family time was exceptional. Beef roast, pig roast, and of course, Florida. Grandma did let us know when the party was over, informing us that it was time to turn down the music or close the barn door. The Alden in St. Pete Beach became a family special place to visit. We have been so blessed to be a part of her life and memories. The lake life, snowmobiling, boating, the best beach volleyball tournaments, and of course, Kitty Cat at the Tiki Bar. The special birthday boat rides, the potty dances, but no matter what, she was our biggest cheerleader. When the boys were cutting the lawn, she always made sure they had a fresh, cold beer in their hand. She was the best mom, grandma, Gigi Ma, mother-in-law, and grandmother-in-law. Whether you were born into the family or married in, you would never know the difference in how you were loved. She had the same big heart for all. Grandma and Grandpa showed us what love was all about. And the only name you might know her, not know her by, was her special name reserved for Grandpa, Sugar Babe. Every night before bed, he would kiss her goodnight and say, "Good night, Sugar Babe." We know she is back to getting her nightly kisses. Although this is hard for us, we know when we lose someone we love, we must learn not to live without them, but to live with the love they left behind.
The family requested if someone here in the audience would like to share a memory, we're going to open it up at this time. To you can either stand, you don't have to come down here, but if you want to share a good memory of Sarah Spruce, we'd like you to share a good memory at this time. Anybody?
Yes.
Oh, that was okay. I thought you were handling it. Anyone here? Okay. All right, I'm going to go right into a short message here. Scriptures that I read during some of my visits with Sarah Brewis. John chapter 14, verse 1, 2, and 3. The words of Jesus says, "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go and prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again, receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye may be also." Psalms 116, verse 15. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. To the family, loved ones, friends that are here today to remember the life of Sarah Brewis, God sees your pain, your sorrow and sadness today. It is okay to grieve and cry. Crying is not an expression of weakness, but an expression of love for Sarah, and that you will miss her. God sees your pain, and he will help you if you put your faith and trust in him. As we think of the life of Sarah Brewis, we all have good memories today. Sarah was a great woman. To know Sarah is to love her. Sarah was very outgoing, making friends and friendly to everyone that she met. Sarah was kind and polite to everyone. Sarah had a good character about her. We all could learn from Sarah. She never seen the bad in anyone. She always believed there is good in everyone. Sarah loved to read. She liked to bowl and play cards with her grandkids. Sarah was a giver in her life, always wanting to help everyone. That is a gift from God. She was very patient toward her family and grandkids. Sarah was also a great teacher, teaching importance things about being disciplined in finances. Sarah loved her family She was a loving mother, a great loving grandmother. And what you don't see a lot, a great and loving mother-in-law. One of Sarah's greatest passions was all her grandkids and great-grandkids. She would support her grandkids and their school activities by being there. Sarah did not show partiality to any of her grandkids. What Sarah did for one, she would do for all. She catered to each of her grandkids in their own way and passions. Sarah was gifted to cook. She loved to cook for her grandkids. Fridays were a special day of cooking enchiladas for her grandkids because the grandkids loved it. Or those special days that Sarah made homemade fudge or oatmeal cookies. See, I had a privilege to be Sarah's hospice chaplain for a while. I would provide comfort, care, and compassion. I don't remember Sarah being angry or agitated. She smiled a lot during my visits. Sarah was open to God and prayers of comfort. Sarah had faith and peace with God. Some of you here today may ponder the question, why death in our land? None of us like to go to funerals. But to give a simple, simplistic answer, when Adam disobeyed God by eating from the fruit from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil, that God warned Adam not to eat from that tree. And if you do, you will surely die. Not physical death. Adam lived to be 930 years old, but spiritual death. Separation from God. That is why Jesus went to the cross as a redeemed man back to God by the prayer of repentance. But the consequences of Adam's sin brought havoc in our land. It brought old age. Men, have you noticed a few more gray hairs? And that terrible word called death. Ecclesiastes tells us there's a time to work and a time to rest. There's a time to plant and a time to receive the harvest. There's a time to laugh and a time to cry. And there's a time to be born and a time to die. See, it is not how you start this race called life, but how you finish this race. I want to speak to the immediate family for a couple minutes. As the days and weeks goes by, you may have times of grief and sadness of the passing of Sarah Brewis. One thing you have for the rest of your life is all the good memories of Sarah. Those laughs that you had together. Or that special Friday where you enjoyed those homemade enchiladas. Or those good memories that Grandma showed up at your school activities or special events. Or the times you enjoyed the homemade fudge that Sarah made. Or the teaching moments that Sarah used to teach. Or that special time and talk with Mom. Or the serious times where there was a few tears shed. Or when Sarah gave you a big hug. See, no one can steal your good memories of Sarah Brewis. See, I know Sarah was a great mother and had a heart of gold during my last visit. Her children was there right up till Sarah was promoted to heaven. Sarah took care of her family, and her family was taking care of Mom till her last breath. Scriptures that I read was scriptures I read to Sarah during my visits about heaven. Sarah can say the words that none of us can say. She can say, I fought a good fight. I've kept the faith. And I finished my course. It has been said, 1 minute in heaven, and you will never want to come back to earth. Thank you, family, for allowing hospice and spiritual care to provide a little comfort, care, and compassion in a dire situation. Everyone that knew Sarah loved Sarah and was touched and impacted in a positive way by Sarah Brewis. Sarah Brewis will be sadly missed. Sadness and sorrow and pain may endure for a night, but I guarantee you joy comes in the morning. Let us pray. Father God, we thank you, Lord, today for Sarah Brewis, her life, for the many people she's touched, the crowd that is here that was touched by Sarah throughout the years. But Lord, today we don't pray for Sarah because we know that she is with you with no pain, no sickness. She's there with her family that's there. But Lord, today we pray for her family and friends. Lord, those that may be struggling. Lord, those that may be just struggling with grief and sadness. Ask that the Holy Spirit would wrap his arms around every family and friends. And Lord, that you bring comfort in the midst of a celebration of Sarah, that she's home. And Lord, we ask it all in your name, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Can everybody say amen?
Amen.
Shall I? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will love your people in my heart. I, the Lord of wind and flame, I will tend the poor and lame. I will set a feast for them. My hand will say, finest bread I will provide, till their hearts be satisfied. I will give my life to them. Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling.
This concludes the services, and we can come up from the back of the chapel and pay our respects to the family and to Jane. Also, if you wish to go directly to the Riverwalk for the meal, you can. Thank you again for being here. Thank you.
This concludes the service.